the question of integration in terms of the Army Air Corps did come to the forefront, in particular when it was announced that the Army was going to build a field here at Tuskegee to train on a separate basis the cadets for the 99th Pursuit Squadron, and that they were going to train the mechanics and technicians at a base in Illinois called Chanute Field. The word, the discussion was just 40 miles down the street in Montgomery, Alabama, you have Maxwell Field, Gunter Field. Further 50 miles, you got Craig Field in Selma. And in Florida and Texas, you have many fields. You're training American, French, Canadian, British, and other cadets. Why can't you train these cadets there? And our government said, Nix Nine, no, can't do that. Their doctrine was the same, separate but equal. They said, we're going to spend $1.5 million to build this field at Tuskegee, and the training will take place there. The field will be equal, on par with any other training field in the Air Corps. At the moment, it was more important to take advantage of this opportunity and break the barrier of this Air Corps and get into the mix of things than it was for an upheaval of demonstrations for integration. Therefore, the young men, very wisely, and upon the advice of elders, decided that they would go into the training with full knowledge that it was segregated and use it as a springboard or platform to overcome that myth. And there were strong feelings about the Negro being able to operate something as complicated as an aircraft. And some of those feelings were honest. They really thought that the Negro type was inferior physically and mentally and could not operate an aircraft. Therefore, the challenge and the opportunity outweighed, for the moment, any type of activity toward integration.